Bolt of Polymorphing? This bolt has been enchanted with powerful magic, glowing slightly with almost a green inner light. If the bolt finds its target once it is fired, the target must make a save versus polymorph or be transformed into a squirrel. Target must save versus polymorph or be turned into a squirrel permanently. That's awesome. I'm not using crossbows currently. So that's like that spell mentioned the squirrel. I mean, that spell scroll mentioned a version that turns the opponent into a squirrel. Well, let's get these scrolls. This goes to our cleric. Improved invisibility and greater malazon. Let me try to learn them. Well, actually, she has the slots right now for it. I might as well give it to Dinah here. Done. Oh, she can't learn this one. It's an enchantment charm. Okay. So now she has improved invisibility. Might as well memorize it twice. And I have, we got fire shield. I think I'll keep fire shield for now. Hopefully I'll get some more, another level 4 slot soon. Alright. I wanted to get some potions. Let's see. 4. I could sell these Ankh-Egg heads here. 4, 8, 9. Elixir of Health. I'll just keep her with Elixir of Health. I'll get 9 of them then.
Why me?
Oh, what about 2 of each? They come in packs of 2? Wait. Oh, I didn't buy them. I didn't completely buy. Okay, never mind. Still need 7 more. I must have hit cancel.
Why me?
Because you might need the healings. Done. Oh, then we go by. Okay. Understood. Damn it, I want to split them up. Thank you. I got them each with 4. Whatever. See if we can sell him anything. Flail plus 1. I think this might be a quest item. Nestor's dagger. So I think I'll hold on to that. The egg is worth 1250 if someone would buy it. He won't buy the Ankh egg shells, damn it. Take my crap. Okay. Just a few things here. Extra healing, though. It's gotta be useful. So arrows plus 1, plus 1. And plus 1. There's arrow of fire. Ice and ice. Acid. Fire. Here. That's another 80. Fire. Biting. And arrows plus 2. This is arrows plus 1. I got more arrows of fire. More arrows of fire. Arrow of piercing. Dart of wounding. And darts. And dart of stunning. Oh, this elixir of health. Let's give this to her. Might as well stack it up. Potion of absorption. Six. Okay. Micromanaging complete, I believe. Let's take a look around, I guess, some more.
All right.
Empty.
Sure.
Hey, how are things going?
Ooh, 52 gold. Hello?
Always willing to speak to new friends.
I knows why I've seen you before. You're the people that are giving an ass to the Iron Throne. It's nice to meet you. Pleasure's mine. If you're here to go on Ike Cascadi and Vendar's tour, then make sure you bring back a little treasure for us. Fenrus took the tour, but he didn't bring back a thing. He just sits on the dock bragging about his trip. Huh. Someone named Ike is giving tours of Durlag's tower. I would assume they only take people through rooms that have been cleared of traps, but perhaps I should ask someone who has taken the tour. There's a man named Fenrus who has done so. I can find him near the docks. Another commoner.
What are you bothering me for?
My husband says he'll take me on Ike's tour of Durlag's tower just as soon as we sell more sheep in Baldur's Gate. I'm ever so excited. You should talk to Fenrus down by the docks if you're interested. He's taking the tour.
Yes, we've heard of that. Well, I don't dare go in here. Is this a... It's not a bookcase, is it?
Kagan says, "Oh, hamster! Could you persuade your person to get a move on? Him standing there, counting the air? Don't get us no further."
Min says, what?
Oh, Boo informs me that you have said something. It is rude to address Boo directly, especially you, for Boo doubts your commitment to stomping your feet on the neck of evil.
I only suggested you begin stomping your foot anywhere. You're like to take root as you were.
Oh, I am sorry. The contemplation of thoroughly butt-kicked wickedness has transported us.
Transported, eh? Not so well that your feet wouldn't do better. Let's move.
That's not a bookcase.
Yeah, I'm not picking that with these people here.
Sure.
So he doesn't like that Mint's been standing around, even though he's been standing around as well. Out we go.
Step right up! Step right up! Why me?
We'll step over here instead. Oh, got a barrel. Empty. I don't know if we should pick that with these people around. Are we far enough away from people?
Good job.
So far, so good.
Why me? Why me?
All right, all right.
Ooh, 4 gold. We're rich.
As directed.
All right, all right.
Hello? Nobody around? Chainmail, not magical. Longsword. History of Om. Grabbed it. History of Om. Cool. Well, that's a little bit more of the longest side as far as Baldur's Gate books go. Sweet.
Mine now. I look forward to reading that one.
Why me?
Not you, me.
Why me?
Well, I wasn't sure what I was expecting from this place, but this is a little different. Ulgoth boy? Hello, Ulgoth boy. Never mind, if you can either go that far, never mind.
Alright.
We need to go around. Oh, because there's a fence there. Never mind. Getting you guys all confused. Right. Hello.
Welcome to our little village.
That guy from Waterdeep sure keeps to himself. He only leaves his house a couple times a month. There's another new face in town, a warder to Haven who keeps to himself. The reclusive scholar. Side of the fence, as it were. Water Daven? Is that how you say it? So this is the bar or inn. Shandalar says, I know of you. You're of an odd countenance. I can count pretty darn high, too. I have need of you. What say you to this? I do not know who you are. Introduce yourself, and we shall see if I can help you. I am Shandalar, and I am the default benefactor of this place. My home is here, as are my major interests. I take interest in whoever comes this way, and you are very interesting indeed. I should like you to perform a task for me, a small thing, really, but something I do not have time for myself. I need you to go to another place and retrieve an item of mine. Let me guess, Durlag's Tower. Very simple, and if you succeed, I will think all the better of you. What say you to this? Why do you need me for this task when you seem more than capable? Well, he did just say he doesn't have the time. I have other things that call my attentions, so it is more convenient that you go. Perhaps I know you not, and this serves as a good measure of you. Already I know you are more interested in the why, and not so much the profit. Will you do this? Wish I could choose profit. Not right now. I need time to prepare. Do not take long. This task needs attention soon. Well, what the hell is it? Are you ready for your task now? My cloak must be found relatively quickly. Alright, I'll come back to you.
You're new. I can tell.
Thanks. What be in here? Therella. Okay, hold on 1 second, guys. Okay.
Good job.
I'm glad you approve. Just make sure there's no one about. Bookcase should be fine. History of the Bell and the Depths. I've read that one.
What's Therella. Your tale?
Greetings, adventurers. You must excuse me if I'm nary a happy word to share this day. There's been a loss in the family, you see. Worry not, lady. Is there anything that we could do to help? Unless you wish to search for my errant son, then no. Tell us the tale, and we might be able to help. I have, or perhaps I should say had, a son named Dalton. He fell in with the crew in adventures from Waterdeep. Dalton was always obsessed with the idea of being a hero. Alas, he has neither the brains nor the ability. Such is a mother's lot in life, however, to watch her children perform acts of idiocy, despite her warnings or concerns. My poor boy took these acts of idiocy to the extreme. He and his thick-skulled cohorts took it upon themselves to plumb the depths of Durlag's tower. They bought a ward token from that shyster Gulkin and made ready to leave. Though I begged and cried, Dalton still insisted on going. The band never returned. I fear that they were destroyed by the mad dwarf's machinations. That is the tale, sad but true. Oh my god, it's horrible. Rest easy, woman. We will find your son, if he still lives. Thank you so much. Such kindness from strangers is unheard of in this harsh life. I will await Dalton's return with breathless anticipation. Yes, hope he's not dead. Therella's missing son. In Ulgoth's spirit, a woman named Therella asked us to look for her errant son in Durlag's tower. The boy's name is Dalton. Indeed. Please keep looking for my poor son. I don't know how much longer I can bear to be apart from him. Is this a staircase? It looks like a staircase, doesn't it? But it's not.
Why me?
One of us is missing. Bradwin.
Tis a fine day to die.
All right.
No one's gonna die today. At least I hope not. Ulgoth boy here.
You funny looking.
Oh, thanks. My mama says the so-called heroes are thieves, murderers, rapers, pillagers, kobold abusers, bad cooks, dregs of society, dog kickers, bribe takers, bullies, lowlifes, and general all-around losers. I'm not sure about that. We kick wolves, not dogs, unless they're war dogs. And we do abuse kobolds on a regular basis. Nice kid.
All right.
All right.
Why me?
We're stuck. Here we go.
Why me?
What's this place? In this place? Oh, there's a downstairs to it. What the hell? What is this?
Sure.
I don't think we want to stand on that. This is a false door. Behind it is solid rock. Ditto. Ditto. What about this? That's not a door at all. Yeah. I hear things behind there. I don't want to step into that. I don't know what that is. S? S is that way.
Hmm.
Okay. I have no idea.
Sure.
Alright. I don't know. Very curious, though. I wonder if that may be a portal to, Durlag's tower.
Alright.
But you need something to get there. I don't think it would be the wardstone that I have. Who's this guy's name? Delsferftanion.
Blast it thrice over. I am through with it, I am so. Tis no living left here, none.
What do you want? I ask you, say quick now. I close soon and not open for customers who not come.
Close soon? You're outside. Good merchant, what is your worry? You seem troubled.
Yeah, you all nice now, but no gold, right? Tis same all day, every night, every day, night too sometimes. Nice people come look and say nice and leave. I lose patience for the nice to look at pretty to hold, but don't buy a suffering thing. You here to buy, or just say nice and leave?
I might be interested. Tell me, what exactly do you deal in?
I sell the small and shinies for the tourists in the Durlag's Tower, but there are none now there. Bandits on the roads to keep the people off and away, so I'm stuck with all this stock I am. Ward tokens I have of all shapes and size, some I found by elven ruin and some I made myself. I made. Maybe some good or maybe some bad, but don't they all look pretty? I tell you what I will. I'll sell you everything I have you buy for low price of 500 gold is all. Then I go home where they appreciate a bauble shine. Buy or no and walk the walk?
Only 500 gold? Yeah, you have a deal and done. Hell, now I'm doing it.
Good and done. Now take it all and get out so I can pack and go. There's enough of my time in this place gone and lost from me.
Okay. I have bought Del's... what? These are done quests. I have bought Delsferftanion's entire stock if only to get him to shut up. Hopefully there'll be a few useful items in the jumble. So we picked up some stuff. Oil of fiery... Oh, because we dropped on the ground. Okay. So, and two more ward stones. A gold ring. A silver ring. A silver necklace. And an onyx ring. And some kind of magical leather armor. And a regular short sword. I need that. Leather armor plus one. I'll have that back then. And then we picked up oil of fiery burning and an antidote. Okay.
A decent kicking for goodness.
So many we meet are lacking.
What are you here for again? You're back. Get out so I can go finish packing up and out.
Alright. No commoners.
You're new in town, too. You friend of that scholar, Mendas? Sorry, never heard of the fellow. Welcome to Ulgoth's Beard. Hope you have a pleasant stay.
Well, hello there, young'un.
My wife says that a Cascadian vendor made a pass at her. I'd break a spine, except my wife says that everyone makes a pass at her. I'd even go so far as to believe her if she wasn't so ugly. Of course, I ain't no foppish nobleman myself. Why am I telling you this? Who knows, guy? If you don't know, you certainly know.
Sure.
Commoners?
You wish to speak? Go on, then.
You're not from these parts. Welcome to Ulgoth's Beard. Thank you, my lady. Polite, too. There's this fellow named Mendas who moved into town this summer. Some of us women folk try to give him a welcome basket. He slammed the door right in our faces. There's another newcomer in town besides me. A man named Mendas moved in just recently. Apparently, he's not all that friendly.
Yes, you have something to say?
I hate this town, I do. Bread never seems to rise properly at this low elevation, and I'm always getting the sniffles from that miserable ocean breeze. Hello, cowman.
Hey, keep it quick. I ain't got time to dawdle.
Hey, pal. Did you hear they found Baldur and in the Trackless Sea, and they're bringing him back to rule Baldur's Gate? I wish it would open up, automatically with... Baldur's final voyage. I hear rumors that the remnants of Baldur's last expedition have been found, but I think tales of his return to rule may be a touch too optimistic. It has been several hundred years since his disappearance, after all. Yeah, that would be quite a feat. Fenrus. Hail, Fenrus.
Away with you, beggar.
Good day. I am Fenrus Bulan. Is there something you need? I am pleased to meet you. Have you gone on the tour of Durlag's Tower? Oh, yeah, he's the one we heard about. Indeed, I have. 'Twas a wonderful tour, although somewhat steep in price. Why do you ask? Perhaps you are entertaining thoughts of following in my footsteps? We thought you might find the time to share some of your knowledge of the tower and of the tour. The tale of that ill-fated tower is a fascinating one. Durlag Trollkiller, a great dwarven hero, built the tower. Over a long and successful career, Durlag amassed a great hoard of treasure. Rumors spoke of rooms full of gems and a great hall strewn with dusty heaps of gold coins. With the aid of hired dwarves, Durlag dug many chambers and passages in the tower and raised raised a lone tower above it, planning it as a seat where he could found a dwarven community and grow old in peace, surrounded by happy, prosperous kin. Instead, doppelgangers, organized and aided by foul mind flayers, slew and impersonated Durlag's companions. After the shocked dwarf discovered the first impersonation, he was attacked by all the others and spent a terror-filled 10-day frantically fighting through his own fortress, chased by monsters who were familiar forms but sought his death. In the end, alone and victorious, he was powerless to stop the fleeing Illithids. Fearful they'd return, Durlag hired the finest craft folk he could find and began to rebuild his tower and the tower beneath as an elaborate succession of traps, magical wards, secret passages, sliding prison chambers, and triggered weapons. For several centuries, things went on like this, as the increasingly eccentric Durlag lived on fungi and, it is cruelly whispered, the bodies of intruders. At length he died, and presumably his bones still lie in some inner room, guarded by thousands of deadly traps. After having seen the first few rooms of the tower myself, I can say that it must be as dangerous as the legends portend. It is a fascinating place to visit, and I strongly recommend that you take the tour. I must be off now. Farewell, and enjoy the tour. Fenrus Bolton. Fenrus Bolan, has told us that Durlag's tower was built by a famous dwarven hero named Durlag Trollkiller. The wealth that he amassed was coveted by a group of mind flayers who used doppelgangers to kill and replace Durlag's family. The hero killed the beast but was driven mad in the process. He entrapped the tower and disappeared within its depths. Can we look on the...
Sure.
Okay. Let's see what's in this stuff here. Empty. What's in here?
I must be speaking to you. Listen, please.
Oh, there's a Mendas.
Hello, friends. It is a pleasure meeting you. You're heroes for Sword Coast. Long wait to meet you. I am Mendas of Waterdeep, quester of small truth in this land. I am in need of a favor. From you. I have money for pay and a big heart for friendship. Can you help a gentle fellow in search for knowledge? It was very awkward to read that. Knowledge is a worthy pursuit, my friend. I will help if I can. Tragic things are happening in this unfair, world. The men with power, they hurt the men with none. They destroy things that teach us better life. I tell you true, it would be better if these men are not born. This Merchants League, these bad men, they find the island to the west. The island has a broken ship and a shipwreck. A very old shipwreck, they say. How did the Merchants League discover the island? They sailed to New World and big storm blew them north. The sailors can't control boat and it almost crashed on island rocks. It is very stormy, but they can see the old wrecked ship. They come back to Baldur's Gate and sell sea charts to Merchants League Counting House, a pox upon them. Why is the Merchants League interested in an island in the middle of nowhere? What does it boast besides dangerous shores and a rotting ship? These merchantmen are greedy. They want island and ship. Is English? Or common, not his native tongue? May their bones rot in nine hells. The merchants want treasures from the New World. The trackless sea is very wide, so Merchants League ships must stop for supplies. They would stop at Evermeet, but Elf places north. Too much. Only place to stop is Sundra on Lantern, but fees are very expensive. Merchant men lose money. Too much in Sundra. The merchant sailors see more than shipwreck on island. They see big harbor also. They want to turn this harbor into new stop for ships from Waterdeep or Baldur's Gate. What about the shipwreck? The Merchants League sailors see markings on the ship. The shipwreck hero is Baldurand's. These men, they think that Baldurand had much treasure on his final voyage. Maybe this is true, but ship also has many artifacts. These things hold knowledge of Baldurand's fate. I wish to recover the ship's logbook. I will solve mystery of Baldurand's final voyage. Merchants League will destroy my artifacts to get treasure. This must not happen. If you help me, I get things precious to me. You get treasure? Merchant men get nothing. You will help, yes? Though foiling the plans of innocent merchants grates on my conscience, I will help you. I charter boat forthwith. There is small problem, though. These men that find island, they keep the sea charts locked up. In Baldur's Gate, there is building in northeast of city called Merchants League Counting House. To find it, just go northeast from Elf Song Tavern. The sea charts, they are in there. Most likely, captain of ship will have them. I do not know such things as chart retrieval, but you are hero, and it is no problem for heroes. There might be small danger, so I give you some gold for the charts. I will wait for you here.
Better than the common merchant. How much gold are you speaking of?
I can spare 2,000 gold pieces for the charts.
I'm on my way.
Please hurry, friends. I need charts soon. Merchants prepare ships as we speak. Mendas has sent us to the Merchants League counting house in the city of Baldur's Gate. We are to obtain their sea charts for him. The counting house should be located in the northeastern quadrant of the city.